Today, we will be explaining the mask tool in Inkarnate. Inkarnate has two mask layers. These are layers that are always underneath all of your assets and filters, and are paintable with textures. The default textures vary depending on the style of map you have chosen to make. The two mask layers available are foreground and background. When starting a new map, the background is exposed. You can use the Add option to expose the foreground, and you can use the Subtract option to expose the background. This is most commonly used when making a world map, with the background being the water and the foreground being the land. There are several ways to add and subtract your mask layers. First, you have the Edge brush, the star-shaped icon at the top. From this menu, you can change the size of your brush and also change the roughness. The roughness manipulates just how detailed your outline is. Next, you have the Circle brush. This is your standard circle brush option with smooth edges. Third, you have the Grid option. This option adds and subtracts the space of a whole grid square. There are also several polygon tools. The square makes squares and rectangles, the circle makes circles and ovals, and the polygon has a field where you can denote the number of sides you want in your shape. These shape tool options also have the option for fill. For this, you can choose a texture to fill in the space that you are adding. Down at the bottom, there are two more options. The first one is a paint bucket. This will allow you to outline an area and then fill it in with one click of a button. The newest mask tool feature is down at the bottom. This one will allow you to select an area of foreground or background and move it to another area of your screen. This is especially useful for moving continents on a world map. The final options within the mask tool are the mask effects. These are accessible through any of the add and subtract options. The stroke will modify the outlining of your foreground. You can change the size or color. The outline will be just outside of your stroke. It defaults to zero, so if you want to see this option, you'll need to change the value in the neighboring box. Outer shadows will determine if there is a shadow on the background side of your outline, and inner shadows will determine the shadow on the foreground side of your outline. You can modify these by adjusting the number in the neighboring field. Ripples appear on the background side of your mask outline. You can use the options to manipulate how many and how far apart they appear, as well as their color and opacity. Be sure to check the description below to find all shortcuts related to the mask tool. Now you know everything you need to know about the mask tool settings. For more tooltips, time lapses, or Inkarnate tricks, be sure to like and subscribe.